to the Royal Rumble is in full stride. Hello once again, everybody. Welcome to Heat. Michael Hayes and the coach at ringside.
Well, Coach, undoubtedly the Royal Rumble match, the fastest and most exciting 60 minutes on television. Wait till you get to see it, and we'll talk more about that Royal Rumble match in just a little bit. I'd like to look at Molly.
Yeah. It's going to be a tremendous one-on-one match as we kick things off. It's Crash and Steve Blackman.
I would imagine Blackman's not in that good of a mood, Coach, considering on SmackDown, Blackman lost the hardcore title to Raven. An upset.
Hello once again, everybody, and welcome to Heat. Michael Hayes and the coach. Happy New Year, everybody. Michael, we're less than a month away now from the Royal Rumble, and the Royal Rumble match now has its first two participants, Kane and none other than his brother, The Undertaker.
And of course, 28 more lucky WWF superstars will be entered in the Royal Rumble, and they all are going after the victory in the Royal Rumble that brings you the shot at the WWF Championship at WrestleMania.
Wow. And Michael, after what we saw this past week, the World Wrestling Federation, as we head into the year 2001, is very cloudy. We do know who's in control again, but right now, so many things are up in the air. Mr. McMahon absent this past week on Raw and SmackDown, and Stephanie said he was helping out at a soup kitchen. What was that all about?
Well, now, Mr. McMahon has been known to give his presence as well as his money to many charities over the years. I don't know why so many people have a problem believing that, and why
Michael, I live near Greenwich, Connecticut in the States.
Okay.
There are no soup kitchens in Greenwich, Connecticut.
Oh, wow. Are you saying because a bunch of rich people live there?
Exactly.
I guess there's no homeless people there either.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
Let's go all the way. Oh, Blackman. Wow. And yes, Blackman is not in a good mood after losing the hardcore title on SmackDown. But, Coach, are you going to go all the way and say Trish was with Mr. McMahon? Do you know that?
It sure sounded like her on the phone.
Look, you know girls, when they get a little giggly, a little hot under the collar, they all sound the same.
Well, that got Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley very hot under the collar. She went straight to Teston Albert. She wanted to know where Trish Stratus was. Trish was not at Raw. So Teston Albert, a tag team match against Too Cool. Out comes Stephanie. When Stephanie wants something to happen, it seems like she's a chip off the old block. She makes it happen. Too Cool beats TNA with the help of Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley.
That's true. Then it apparently appeared as though Test and Albert had settled their differences.
Oh, wow.
Albert trying to give Test a good piece of advice. Don't cross the boss. Test, man.
Take a crash out onto Steve Blackman.
What a pescado. A big dive over on the floor, and now Crash has to seize this opportunity. Blackman's hurting.
Wow, there goes another old big crossbody. Here's a hook of the leg. This could be it, but a kick out by Steve Blackman.
What was so surprising about Test and Albert?
Oh, wow.
They redeemed themselves from losing on Raw and won against Too Cool on SmackDown, but they wouldn't have. They would not have won the match had Test not helped Albert. Albert was about to be pinned by Grandmaster Sexy.
Why did Albert turn on Test? Here's a cover hook of the leg and a kick out by Crash. Why did Albert turn on Test? Did Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley have something to do with that?
May have.
You know, it seems like it appears to me like Albert and Trish Stratus have a newfound relationship with the McMahons. My question is, where does that leave Test?
Well, who cares?
I care.
Why?
Because
he's never done nothing for you.
Test has been left out in the cold.
Well, he needs to be left out in the cold.
Well, we have a tremendous hour here on Heat, so please, you can join us. A little bit later on, we're going to be taking a tribute, if you will, to the former WWF Commissioner Mick Foley right here on Heat. Also, tremendous action. We'll have Billy Gunn.
Oh,
wow, nice backslide by Crash.
Billy Gunn taking on Val Venus. And, ladies and gentlemen, you do not want to miss this special video tribute to Mick Foley. It is unbelievable, and it just, you know, kind of punches the point home that Mick's been fired and he's gone.
I don't know why you enjoy that so much. I really don't.
Well, because Mick needed to be home with his wife and his kids. It was a blessing in disguise. It takes a little while to realize those things.
Well, now, Steve Blackman straight into the legs of Crash Holly. Well, now that the McMahons are back in charge, I mean, I don't feel like anybody is safe, but it appeared like on SmackDown, Stephanie was going to be fair. We'll get to that a little bit later on in the hour. A tremendous hour coming up. Also, Hardcore Holly against Perry Saturn, one-on-one. But right now, the action is fast and furious here between Crash and Steve Blackman, two great former Hardcore champions. Here's a roll-up by Steve Blackman and a kick-out by Crash. Right now, it's going to be a tremendous, tremendous hour, as I mentioned, Michael, and we're only 3 weeks away from the Royal Rumble. I cannot wait. The anticipation this year for the 2001 Royal Rumble may be bigger than it's ever been before.
Oh, good counter by Blackman. Crash Holly has won many a match with the turnaround bulldog.
Wait a second. Steve Blackman has a submission move on Crash, and that's it. Crash Holly submits to Steve Blackman.
Here is your winner, the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman.
Well, I tell you what, Steve Blackman, very impressive, Michael, here on Heat. Nothing Crash Holly can do from that submission move. But I tell you what, still to come, a tremendous hour here on Heat. The one, Billy Gunn, goes one-on-one with the right to censors, Val Venus. Also, Hardcore Holly, toe-to-toe with Perry Saturn. Dio Brad will take on Kay Quick, and Taz goes face-to-face with Taka Michinoku. But up next, a musical tribute to former World Wrestling Federation Commissioner Mick Foley. Stick around, we're coming right back.
This portion of the WWF is brought to you by Castrol GTX. Drive hard!
You look so radiant.
Introducing a breakthrough in reducing the appearance of aging.
Have you been on vacation?
It contains an exclusive vitamin B and E complex called vitaniacin. Olay Total Effects fights the seven signs of aging.
You look beautiful.
New Total Effects from Olay. Proven to reveal a remarkable beauty transformation.
Son, life isn't all about money. Nah, family, health, happiness, those are the important things.
I think we both know what I'm trying to say is it's time we raised your allowance.
Got some extra cash? For $49.99 each, you can get these super cool Nintendo 64 games, all bestsellers and all player's choice.
Grandpa?
Hey, at these prices, maybe you can get two. Rated E for everyone.
Vertical Limit is hands down the most entertaining movie of the holiday season.
Grab my hand! Grab it!
An adrenaline-pumping, heart-stopping, emotionally charged adventure.
We're bringing you home!
Strap yourself in.
Hang on!
For the most fun you'll have at the movies this year. Vertical Limit. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
Welcome back to Heat, everybody. Right now, let's take you to a musical tribute of our former World Wrestling Federation Commissioner, Mick Foley.
The new Commissioner of the World Wrestling Federation, Mick Foley!
What makes people so blind? Never seem to see. Every story has to end. Now it's time for you and me. Can't you make me wrong? 'Cause I'm not sure that I'm so strong. Now I see what was to be. Remember just to relive all the pain.
will certainly miss Mick Foley. Well, still to come, tremendous one-on-one action, Val Venus and the one, Billy Gunn. Also, Hardcore Holly takes on the Radicals, Perry Satter. And D'Lo Brown tries to rowdy down Kay Quick. But up next is Pat Taka, one-on-one. We're coming right back.
The countdown to the Royal Rumble is on. Hi, everybody. Kevin Kelly on the road with Slam Jam Sunday, January 21st. The first huge event of the year 2001 emanates from New Orleans, Louisiana. And the Big Easy will be anything but easy for those who look to survive and be victorious in what is traditionally one of the biggest events of the year, the Royal Rumble. Imagine 30 WWF superstars all vying to be crowned Royal Rumble champion. Who will it be this year? We'll find out in a matter of weeks. We invite you to be part of the Royal Rumble either on pay-per-view on Sunday, January 21st, or by seeing it live as it happens at a Famous Players location. They're all across Canada. The number on your screen right now, you order advance tickets, and you'll definitely be in the house for the Royal Rumble on Sunday, January 21st. So it's all coming to a head Sunday, January 21st, and the big question on everybody's mind, who will win the Royal Rumble 2001?
World Wrestling Federation Home Video presents two new home videos destined for greatness and bound for glory with never-before-seen exclusive footage. Break Down the Wall featuring Chris Jericho and Kurt Angle, it's true, showcasing the Federation's only true Olympic hero.
Also, watch for the new WWF DVD King of the Ring and SummerSlam. All these titles and more available in stores on December 12th. Available at Walmart. We sell for less every day.
Are you ready? The Angels have arrived. Critics are blown away. It's a high-octane rock'em sock'em good time. A total blast. A great roller coaster ride. Charlie's Angels, now playing.
Ordinarily, the family who owns this couch could be found enjoying their favorite program on Rogers Cable. Tonight, however, they can be found saving money on a movie at a nearby Famous Players cinema, thanks to the Rogers VIP program. Which, of course, begs the question, what were we thinking? Now save on Famous Players movie tickets from Rogers VIP program. Call 1-888-ROGERS-1.
It started off as a crazy idea, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to drive around the world. People ask why. Well, once somebody told me I could do anything if I really wanted to. And you know what? I believed him. My body may be paralyzed. My life doesn't have to be.
The Canadian Paraplegic Association helps thousands of Canadians with spinal cord injuries rebuild their lives. If you need help or want to help, call the CPA.
Oh, great.
What's the matter?
Here comes Mr. Mouth.
The mood's about to change.
Yeah.
Your mood's changing right now.
It's not changing. Well, he's the one-man crime spree. He's the thug from Brooklyn, New York.
Put your hand on your wallet there.
Introducing first, from the Red Hook section of Brooklyn, New York, weighing 248 pounds.
Over here trying to pickpocket somebody.
Well, it seems to me like Taz is getting a little bit cocky, a little bit big for his britches the last couple of weeks.
Uh-oh. Is Taz headed this way? Oh.
What does he want now? Again?
You stupid ass! You suck! Suck the wind! You'll always suck! Pay attention to Hayes, because you suck!
See? Now see? This guy Taz, he knows his stuff. Come on, you got to be able to take constructive criticism in this business.
I can take constructive criticism as much as the next guy, but him telling me to listen to you, please!
Okay, Coach, let's look at it this way. Between the two of us, one of us is a legend. Who should listen to who? Okay?
You forgot to put in his own mind.
Okay, uh-oh, another bad Godzilla movie coming up.
You, American thug, you have scary looks, you have crazy accent, but can you fight? You must know our teacher taught us well. Prepare to die!
He does have scary looks.
Indeed.
I'll tell you what, Funaki doesn't say much, but he makes a point when he says something, doesn't he? And Taz seems amused by all this. Nevertheless, you can never discount the athletic ability of Taka Michinoku inside that squared circle, a former WWF light heavyweight champion.
Well, certainly, we've seen him go toe-to-toe with some of the best. You remember
Triple H one time.
That was a tremendous match in the year 2000.
As a matter of fact, I think Taka probably relishes the idea of being the underdog in the match.
You know, speaking of the year 2000 real quick, not to relish or dwell on it, but what a year the year 2000 was. Can 2001 top it here in the World Wrestling Federation?
I don't know, but I'm sure willing to find out.
Oh, certainly. I love being along for the ride.
I'll tell you what, Steve Austin, Stephanie McMahon Helmsley, there's a little trouble brewing there.
Well, certainly. You know, Steve Austin came out on SmackDown.
Oh
wow, what a nice move by Taz, taking it to the arm of Taka. Steve Austin didn't demand. He asked for a title shot from Stephanie. Stephanie declined, and then Stone Cold, being the gentleman that he is, said, well, there's no reason. There shouldn't be any hard feelings, so there's no reason why we shouldn't drink a beer together. Then he toasted Stephanie. She disrespected him by not drinking the beer. Then and only then did Stone Cold pour the beer on top of Stephanie's head.
Okay, now for the correct version, ladies and gentlemen. Stone Cold Steve Austin came out and said he wasn't playing any more games, and he wasn't going to wrestle her silly little matches unless he got a WWF title shot.
Which he deserved.
This is not a precedent. Yeah, but so does The Rock,
so does
The Undertaker, so does Rikishi. You can't let the inmates run the asylum, so to speak. And Stone Cold.
Oh, wait a second. Oh, wow, what a snap suplex by Taz.
While toasting Stephanie McMahon Helmsley, forcefully put the two beer cans together so beer spilt on Stephanie.
Simple mistake. But I tell you what, Stephanie came out later on at SmackDown, and what was supposed to be a handicap match.
It was.
Well, you know what I'm talking about. It was The Rock and The Undertaker supposed to take on Rikishi. Well, out comes a beer-drenched Stephanie. Here's a roll-up, nice sunset flip, and a kick out by Taz. And she added William Regal and Kane to the mix in the corner of Rikishi. Obviously not happy about the events of the night on SmackDown.
Well, I agree with you. I think The Rock and The Undertaker felt the wrath of Stephanie because of Stone Cold Steve Austin. It was the Rattlesnake's fault. And if Rock and Taker are looking for a culprit, somebody to blame, look no further than the Rattlesnake, who's only in it for himself. He has no friends, wants no friends, never will have friends.
You know, talking about the
T-Bone.
Wait a second. Taz has Taka set up for the T-Bone suplex. Wow, what torque. But you talk about Mr. McMahon, what do you think was going through his mind? Eventually he got to see. I don't know if he's watching that night, but he has seen what Stone Cold has done. And we know the past, the vicious past that Mr. McMahon and Stone Cold Steve Austin have had. And after seeing that, it all could come back again.
Well, I think the last time we saw Mr. McMahon, the last two times, nice by Taka. Good savant kick. Mr. McMahon.
Oh, wait a second. Taka with the back blow. Nobody else. Oh, wait a second. Taz has sunk in the Taz Vision. And this one, as quickly as it started, is now over.
What I started to say is Mr. McMahon granted Austin his wishes a couple of weeks ago, hence giving Austin the match with Kane. I don't know if Mr. McMahon will be that nice when he returns.
I don't know what he's saying.
Does the VO guy have the same agent that Taka's VO guy does?
Oh, you have made it clear. Just another victim. So you think, but Confucius said, if your future is so bright, why you wear shades?
Did we miss a cocktail party or a happy hour or something?
If we did, I'm not happy about it.
No, whatever. Taz with the victory.
Well, plenty more still to come. It's going to be Val Venus one-on-one with Billy Gunn. Also, Hardcore Holly versus Perry Saturn. But up next, D'Lo Brown and Kane Quick is riding. Stick around. We're coming right back.
Now, in this exclusive offer, not one, not two, but five Stone Cold videos, including Cause Stone Cold Said So, Austin 316, Austin vs. McMahon, Hell Yeah Stone Cold Saga Continues, and Stone Cold Steve Austin, Lord of the Ring.
Also watch for the WrestleMania Legacy box set and the new exclusive WWF Hat Pack. All these titles and more available in stores on December 15th. Specially priced at all future Shop Music locations in-store and online.
Son, life isn't all about money. Nah, family, health, happiness, those are the important things. I guess what I'm really trying to say is,
how much will it cost to keep this from your mother?
$49.99. That's all you need for these super cool Nintendo 64 games. All bestsellers and all players' choice. Hey, at these prices, maybe you can get two.
Grandpa?
Rated E for everyone to M for mature.
Introducing the most powerful Duracell Ultra ever. With new M3 technology, it's the most powerful alkaline battery in the world.
When you have a cold, even small tasks can be a big pain. So get Dayquil, the daytime non-drowsy, congested, stuffy head, sore throat, coughing, aching, fever, so you can get back to your day medicine from the makers of NyQuil.
Along with St. Nick, I'm Darren Millard. The Hockey News would like to wish everyone the best of the holiday season. Don't you absolutely love this time of the year?
Oh, yeah, what's not to love? Crowded parking lots, overinflated prices, and that one relative that just refuses to go home.
I'm going to go out on a limb here. You didn't get what you wanted for Christmas?
They were sold out.
It's the Hockey News Puck Poll. Forget the Grinch who stole Christmas. Maybe Nick did it. Log on, cast your vote. We'll have the results on New Year's Day.
Welcome back to Heat, everybody. Another tremendous one-on-one match as we head towards the Royal Rumble. Only 3 weeks away. The road to WrestleMania stops at the Royal Rumble.
Well, not exactly 3 weeks. I mean, roughly 3 weeks.
Well, you know.
If you want to be precise like I am.
Representing Motown, D'Lo Brown.
You know, Coach, I said it earlier, the Royal Rumble match is the most exciting, the fastest 60 minutes on television. And, I mean, it can be a career-defining moment for the winner of the Royal Rumble. Obviously, reaching an objective, a goal that you should start out with when you start in this industry, that's to wrestle for the WWF Championship in the main event at WrestleMania, and that's what the winner of the Royal Rumble match garners.
And you talk about the potential for this Royal Rumble match. For the first time in several years, Michael, you have all the top superstars in the World Wrestling Federation. If Triple H gets back, that's all I'm saying. I don't know if he'll be back or not, but you got all of them primed and ready. It's a little premature to say, maybe,
right,
but they would probably all be a part of the Royal Rumble match. Who knows who could come out of that victorious?
Okay, hush up.
Oh, jeez. Not again.
What?
Due to your prejudice, I refuse to acknowledge the ignorant masses here tonight.
Then don't.
How can he not? There's so many of them.
Instead, I will speak to my brother and our people in our native tongue. Me pela kiasi, apne Asian loca de chumne.
Oh, yeah!
There's him coming again, Roddy Wing!
Outstanding! It's about time somebody shut Tiger up!
Here we go.
Probably got him rowdy.
Here we go.
I think our producer Tommy's standing up in the truck. Tommy Carlucci's taking it old school style.
He's using that style.
It's the game three, get it about to get crowded. You didn't know, Santa Claus gonna pile it. Stepping through the dust of the Nifty Fall.
Oh, wait a second. Uh-oh. D'Lo said, I've had enough of that.
Yeah, you want to get rowdy? How about rowdy this?
Wow, this should be a tremendous one-on-one match.
Getting back to the Royal Rumble match, it's hard to say, you know, whom will be in at this time. The only ones we know for sure, as you astutely said earlier. Nice kick there by Kay Quick.
Oh, wow.
The Undertaker and Kane. We don't know who's going to be WWF champion by the time we get to the Royal Rumble. Will it still be Kurt Angle? But if I'm WWF champion, I'm relishing the thought of anybody being in that Royal Rumble, because I'm going to have to defend against the winner, provided I still have the title at WrestleMania, because people get hurt in the Royal Rumble match.
Oh, absolutely. Oh. I mean, it's dangerous.
It's every man
over the top rope.
All the way to the floor.
Here's a cover by Kay Quick and a kick out by D'Lo.
I mean, take a look at, just for an example, one example, Taka Michinoku last year.
Mm-hmm.
Madison Square Garden, Taka was out for 3-4 months with a separated shoulder, just for being thrown over the top rope to the concrete floor. Nice torque there by D'Lo.
And Michael, do you think the anticipation this year is bigger than it's ever been? Because the World Wrestling Federation is now at all-time height. It's bigger than it's ever been. So you talk about the Royal Rumble match and the possible participants. You could be talking about The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Kane, The Undertaker. You know, any of these guys could have a shot at winning, do have a shot at winning, but it's only going to be one man.
That's right. It can only be one man, and like you said, it's every man for himself. I've seen friendships and relationships go right out the window because people want to win.
Wait, hold the phone. Tiger Ali Singh taking it to Kay Quick on the outside.
But, I mean, there's just no telling what could happen in the Royal Rumble match, and I mean, think about it. It's one thing that, you know, the Royal Rumble match winner meets the WWF champion at WrestleMania. But this year, WrestleMania, the Astrodome, 67,000 people, the biggest WrestleMania of all time.
It's going to be absolutely huge. I tell you what, the year 2001 has the potential to be the biggest year in the World Wrestling Federation that it's ever seen. But you talk about the year of who? It could be the year of Stephanie McMahon Helmsley. Could be the year of The Rock, the year of Triple H, Stone Cold Steve Austin. So many possibilities. Here's a cover by D'Lo and a kick out by Kay Quick.
Well, one person it probably will not be the year for, unfortunately, and I'm serious here, is Linda McMahon. I wonder how Linda McMahon spent Christmas.
You know, it could not have been good, because obviously she didn't spend it with her daughter Stephanie, who obviously was at Raw on Christmas.
Right. Mr. Well, somebody's got to keep the show going. The show must go on.
I know. Mr. McMahon was
soup
supposedly
kitchen.
At a soup kitchen by himself.
All right. Look, maybe you're not getting this. Okay. We don't know that Trish and Mr. McMahon were together. But if they just so happened had to have been, let it go. Leave it alone.
All right.
He's the boss.
I'll let it go.
And don't even make comments about her.
Okay.
Okay. She's a nice looking girl. Leave it at that.
From this point on, I won't see anything more about her.
Okay.
She wasn't there. But anyway, moving on. What about this past week? I tell you what. What about the Hardy Boys taking on the Radicals? And you know, we've been talking about Lita a lot the last couple of weeks, and it seems like there's a lot of jealousy with Matt Hardy.
Well, you know, we saw last week on Heat. Oh!
Oh, wow, what a big move. What a big maneuver by Kay Quick. Oh, wow, big elbow.
Last week, Jeff Hardy asked his brother, am I seeing a little bit more than friendship feelings here for Lita? Is there some jealousy? And Matt denied it, which we all do.
Well, certainly. There's a cover hook of the leg and a kick out by D'Lo Brown. And now Lita, unfortunately, is going to be out of action for a while.
Well, with that crossface by Benoit. See, when you mess with one radical, you mess with all the radicals. And nobody's been able to prove Benoit wrong so far. I'm not condoning his actions on Lita.
I understand. Now, certainly the Intercontinental Champion is taking on all comers, but at the same time, we may be seeing a more aggressive, not only Chris Benoit, but Dean Malenko and Perry Saturn as well.
Well, this is true. And speaking of Perry Saturn, we're going to see Perry here in just a little bit.
He goes one-on-one with Hardcore Holly. And right now, D'Lo Brown looks to be finishing off Kay Quick.
But if you want to talk about matchups, later on, Val Venus taking on Billy Gunn. Billy trying to get revenge for China and her injuries at the hands of RTC.
Certainly, we want to send our best wishes out to China as well, who obviously career-threatening injuries to her neck and her spine. So right now, our best wishes go to her. But right now, Kay Quick, wow, taking it to D'Lo Brown. Here's a cover. Hook to the leg. This could be it. And it is.
Got it.
Huge win. Wow.
Would you consider this an upset?
Let's say here comes Tiger Ali seeing one to get his hands on Shane Quick, but
I think Tiger's trying to get calf hair.
Well, I tell you what, we mentioned the Royal Rumble is only 3 weeks away. Which one of the 30 superstars will win in 3 weeks?
Superstars, one ring, one man left standing. The WWF Royal Rumble.
And we'll get those little rascals next time.
The Royal Rumble, the first big event of the year. It's right around the corner, Sunday, January 21st, 2001. Hi, everybody. Kevin Kelly once again for Slam Jams. Earlier on, big information about the Royal Rumble, and we are counting down the days to this huge event. Now, traditionally, the Royal Rumble winner gets to face the World Wrestling Federation champion at WrestleMania. This year's WrestleMania is going to be the biggest ever. So who will win, and most arguably, the most important Royal Rumble ever? We'll find out very soon, Sunday, January 21st. We invite you to be part of this event. It's live on pay-per-view at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, but all across Canada, if you don't have pay-per-view, you could go to a famous player's location and see the Royal Rumble live as it happens. Now, the number on your screen right now is important. Give it a call. You can order advance tickets because you don't want to be shut out of the biggest event of the month of January. We're kicking off the new year in style, the first big event of 2001. It's right around the corner. It's the Royal Rumble.
World Wrestling Federation Home Video presents two new home videos destined for greatness and bound for glory with never-before-seen exclusive footage. Break Down the Walls featuring Chris Jericho and Kurt Angle, It's True, showcasing the Federation's only true Olympic hero.
Also, watch for the new WWF DVD King of the Ring and SummerSlam. All these titles and more available in stores on December 12th. All WWF video, DVD, and music available at Zellers.
In a town that had grown cold from tradition, someone is cooking up something special.
Chili pepper and hot chocolate.
Everybody loves the taste.
For your husband to awaken the passion.
Nobody was prepared for the side effects.
You have more of those bean thingies.
Critics are calling it the best comedy of the year. Magical, as delectable as its title.
If I were 20 years younger, your virtue would be in danger.
Chocolat.
I'll come around sometime, get that squeak out your door.
Now playing in select cities, additional cities on Christmas Day.
What is it?
Never has so much power gone into a Duracell Ultra. With new M3 technology, it's the most powerful alkaline battery in the world.
If you happen to see even more people in Moores these days, it's because right now, we're having our year-end clearance sale, which means you'll find suits starting at $130, sport coats at $100, as well as shirts, shoes, and everything else at big savings. After all, while you can get almost anything on sale this time of year, we think you'll find what we have to offer will suit you the best. Well made, well priced, well dressed. Moores.
World Wrestling Federation Home Video presents two new home videos destined for greatness and bound for glory with never-before-seen exclusive footage. Break Down the Walls featuring Chris Jericho and Kurt Angle, It's True, showcasing the Federation's only true Olympic hero.
Also, watch for the new WWF DVD King of the Ring and SummerSlam. All these titles and more available in stores on December 12th. Specially priced at all future Shop Music locations in-store and online.
Not what I had in mind.
30 superstars, one ring, Catch WWF pay-per-views at selected Famous Players theaters. The next best thing to being there.
Welcome back. Let's take you back to SmackDown earlier this week. Undertaker and Rock were in a handicap match against Rikishi, William Regal, and Kane.
Old school!
You hear that? Old school vintage Undertaker. You're going to walk those ropes like nobody else can.
What balance and agility by the nearly 7-foot Undertaker. And a right hand to the European champion as well. Big boot to the face, knocking the Undertaker down.
These two huge brothers are the first ones entered into the Royal Rumble. Don't forget, whoever wins the Royal Rumble is going to get to face the WWF champion, whoever that may be, at WrestleMania.
Well, here comes Rikishi, hammering away on the man that just a few weeks ago threw him off the top of Hell in a Cell. Rikishi suffering a bruised spleen, a lacerated kidney, and now attacking the Undertaker and trash-talking the Rock.
Tell you something, this could get really ugly right here. Can you imagine the feelings that goes through Rikishi every time he looks at the Undertaker?
Oh man, you know, it was the Undertaker who made Rikishi famous, in his words, at Hell in the Cell, King. And here now the European champion William Regal, the left hand to the Undertaker. Regal, and your aggressive, vicious Regal in recent weeks, really taking it to the Undertaker.
But I gotta agree with what Rikishi said. I think what made Rikishi famous was when he ran over Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, oh! Double knee to the face of Undertaker. It was Rikishi who ran over Stone Cold. And then Rikishi dragged The Rock's name through the mud, saying that Rock was to blame for that hit-and-run attack on the Rattlesnake.
No, you know who was really to blame? You know who really orchestrated that?
The Game, Triple H.
Right, and I'd like to take this opportunity to wish Triple H a happy new year.
I'm sure you would.
I bet he had a great Christmas.
Kane with a right hand of The Rock. And look at the double and triple team by this team of Kane, Rikishi, and William Regal. This match is 3-on-2,
Michael. It's a handicap match. What'd you expect?
Orchestrated, set up by Stephanie McMahon Helmsley. Oh. Undertaker with a right hand. It's brother to brother, toe to toe in the ring. And think about the battles these two have had in the past, King.
Look at these shots they're trading.
Both of these men in the Royal Rumble match next month in New Orleans. Oh, one of these men could barely well win that matchup and head to WrestleMania with a title shot, King. Oh, Undertaker with a boot to Kane, losing his own balance, falling in the center of the ring.
You know what, I can't help but recall, Michael, how you thought everything was okay when you thought it was going to be a handicap match the other way. When you thought The Rock and The Undertaker were going to outnumber Rikishi, you thought everything was fine with that, didn't you?
Well, Undertaker needs to make a tag. The Rock wants in. The Rock intense. Can't wait to make that tag, and he does. And here comes the Brahma Bull, exploding out of the chute. Big right hand to William Regal.
He's torched. He's burnt. He's being besmirched.
Yeah, he's being smacked, laid down on him by The Rock.
I mean, The Rock is, he's absolutely molesting Mr. Regal.
Oh, man. Tremendous belly-to-belly by Rock. Right hand to Rikishi. Another to Kane.
Two cheap shots.
And the Brahma Bull, look at him stalking William Regal.
Don't turn around.
The Rock stalking his prey. The Rock calls out the Pine Buster, Kane.
That's not working.
Oh,
that is.
Kane with a clothesline. Undertaker into the ring now.
Oh, look at this.
Kane knocked out of the ring. Right out in front of us. Oh, where's Rikishi going?
What?
Rikishi's staying the hell with this.
Leaving?
Well, Rock wants under Rikishi.
Oh, look at that, Rock him out.
Rock with a strike. Clothesline to the 400 pounder. You can literally feel this arena shake, King. When Rikishi is...
Oh,
no. Blow.
Oh. That hurt me.
The Rock. He wants more of Rikishi. After what happened on Raw Monday Night, King. You can't blame him.
Oh, Rock cracking over those Samoan coconuts. It's got to be very, very painful. Oh!
Oh, Rikishi face to face with the Undertaker.
Oh. Oh! This is not good.
After what happened on Raw Monday Night, Rikishi leaving Rock and Undertaker laying, King, he deserves this.
We're playing Polynesian pinball with the man.
Oh! Guess what?
Yeah.
Dead Man Inc. is open for business. Rikishi.
No!
Can he do it?
Yes!
400 pounds! Chokeslam! Chokeslam! Kane! Kane into the ring from behind of the Undertaker. Regal with Rock. Kane with the Undertaker.
Well, Rikishi almost crippled.
WWF is brought to you by Castrol GTX. Drive hard.
World Wrestling Federation Home Video presents two new home videos destined for greatness and bound for glory with never-before-seen exclusive footage. Break Down the Walls featuring Chris Jericho and Kurt Angle, It's True, showcasing the Federation's only true Olympic hero.
Also, watch for the new WWF DVD, King of the Ring and SummerSlam. All these titles and more available in stores on December 12th. Available at Blockbuster, bringing entertainment home.
Is it possible we bought a lifetime supply of pudding and forgot about it?
I'd say it's entirely possible.
Last night was a night to remember.
Where were you between midnight and 2 a.m.?
We don't remember.
But not for Jesse and Chester.
Leave him alone. He doesn't know anything.
20th Century Fox presents...
Have you seen my car?
Well, I saw the back seat.
Oh, I'm talking about the whole thing.
Dude, where's my car?
I got a really bad feeling in the pit of my stomach. Maybe you should go sit on the toilet.
Now playing only in theaters.
Well, I'll tell you what, as we head to this week on Raw, you've got to believe, Michael, that The Rock and The Undertaker, once again, not happy campers at all.
Hey, what, I'm always happy when Terry comes out here.
Oh, my goodness.
And speaking of happy, what we did not show you was Stephanie McMahon Helmsley's reaction to the carnage in the ring. Stephanie was elated.
I mean, why wouldn't she be?
Right.
I mean,
Rock and Undertaker are laying flat.
She had had a rough night. You know, finally something went her way.
I disagree with you. The Chris Jericho episode went her way. Matt Hardy in a great effort losing to Benoit. That went her way. How about Stephanie setting up Bubba Ray Dudley against Kurt Angle with the WWF title on the line? That went Miss McMahon Helmsley's way.
Oh,
the
yeah.
Only thing that did go her way was the rattlesnake before he here.
Hello. Oh,
Merry Christmas.
Yeah,
Happy New Year.
I almost forgot about the other stuff because the Stone Cold stuff was so good.
I'll give you this much. The crowd enjoyed it.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. I'll admit it.
From Mobile, Alabama, weighing 223 pounds, Hardcore Holy.
I'm expecting a heavy hitting matchup right now. Neither one of these men give a quarter or ask for one.
True. You're talking about two men who obviously spend a lot of time in the gym.
And Holly paying no attention to Perry Saturn whatsoever. That could be a mistake.
Did you see him point at me? He said, "What's up, my main man, coach, ringside?" Yeah.
Looked to me like a look of, how does that idiot keep a job?
No, he wasn't pointing at you.
It's go time here.
Wait, don't use my line. It's go time, Perry Saturn and Hardcore Holly. Here on Heat. I'll tell you what, you know, this will be my second Royal Rumble, and we talked about it a year ago at this time, and I was so excited, didn't know what to expect, but I wonder if this year's Royal Rumble can top last year's Royal Rumble. I know over the next few weeks, we're going to be looking at Royal Rumble moments. You know, last year, of course, the Royal Rumble match, tremendous. Wait a second, here's a kick out by Perry Saturn. And The Rock, we thought it won. Then The Big Show proved that The Rock's feet hit the ground first. Could we have more controversy this year? Anything and everything possibly could and probably will happen.
Well, with so much on the line, nice counter there by Saturn, kicking out the feet of Holly, therefore presenting an uncomfortable landing on the top rope. And now Saturn, this is the mark of a veteran. You seize your opportunities and you go for them right away.
Oh my goodness, how good does she look today? I mean, I hate to dwell on him, but my goodness. I wish you'd stop looking at me too. I'm trying to concentrate on doing my job.
Coach, it's kind of like the lottery. You're not going to win either.
Shut up!
Well, anyway, back to the action in the ring. Certainly appreciate the confidence you have in me each and every week.
Well, I do. I'm still here with you.
True. You can't seem to get rid of me, can you?
No.
We're going to another year and like, oh, damn.
It's like a bad cold.
My mama back home used to say, you're like a bad rash.
Yeah.
It never leaves.
That'll work too.
Yeah. All right, now Perry Saturn taking it to Hardcore Holly. Really trying to work on that left leg and that left knee of Hardcore.
Well, Hardcore, so strong with the upper body. Sometimes you tend to forget how strong Hardcore is with his legs. Take out them tree trunks. Get him on the mat. He's going to be easier to defeat.
You know, what about the week that the World Wrestling Federation champion, we haven't alluded to it yet, Kurt Angle had. We saw him on Raw introduce his family, his cousins, his brothers, and try to sing a Christmas carol.
Well, I'll tell you what,
what about when he introduced his family to Kay Quick?
I gotta agree with Kay Quick. That was the whitest Christmas I've ever seen in my life. Man, those guys were dorks.
They were dorks.
I like Kurt Angle and all, and Saturn right back to that leg. I just don't know about those brothers, man. I wouldn't go double dating with any of them.
Yeah, what about Eric Angle getting put through a table? Wow. But Kurt Angle did get a chance to avenge that. And Olympic slam. Here's a cover by Perry Saturn. Hook of the leg, and wow. Hardcore Holly kicks out just before the count of three. But Kurt Angle did get to Olympic slam. Bubba Ray Dudley threw that table on SmackDown.
Albeit a little bit of help from our WWF Tag Team Champions.
Well, you said it.
Edge and Christian.
See, you brought that up, not me. You always get on me when I bring that kind of stuff up.
Well, you know, Coach, you got to call him like you see him. And had it not been for Edge and Christian, I don't think Kurt Angle would have been able to do the Olympic slam through the table with Bubba.
True. Oh, my goodness.
And you talk about career-defining moments and changes in people's careers. Look at the change of Edge and Christian after this year's WrestleMania.
Well, sure. I mean, they were good before, but they raised the level of their game. I'll give credit where credit's due. Oh, a big power slam by Hardcore Holly on the Perry Saturn and a big clothesline to boot. You know, but they raised the level of their game. And after their match at SummerSlam with the Hardy Boys and the Dudley Boys, which incidentally was voted the match of the year,
right,
Edge and Christian stock and suddenly rose. Wow, a big kick for the sun. Don't even think about shining to Perry Saturn.
Well, you know, I've always, I said this to the Hardys when I first got with them. If you're not getting better, you're getting worse.
Yes. And Edge and Christian are certainly getting better, but so is the entire tag team division. You talk about the Dudley Boys,
ooh,
you talk about, oh,
talk about getting better.
Nice camera shot, boys. Oh, even better camera shot, boys. We're talking about the Hardy. Oh, wow, what a big boot to the face of Hardcore Holly. Distracted by Terry, and that's it. Just like that, a three count. Perry Saturn, huge win with the help of Terry.
What a nice distraction, and what a nice savant kick. And here to me, Saturn may have had a handful of trunks there as well.
Speaking of savant, Terry kind of had... Oh, never mind.
Okay. Don't go there.
I won't go there.
All right.
Well, I tell you what, plenty more to come here on Heat. Well, coming up next, our featured matchup here on Heat. The one, Billy Gunn, goes head-to-head with Val Venus. You don't want to miss it. Come right back.
The home of the Senators, CTV Sports Net East.
The Movie Network on Rogers Digital Choice TV brings you over 150 hit Hollywood movies every month. In December, catch The Green Mile, starring Tom Hanks in a story of a man on death row. Watch Sleepy Hollow, a mystery about murders that have reportedly been committed by a headless horseman, starring Johnny Depp. Order the Movie Network on Rogers today, and you could win one of four all-inclusive signature vacation trips to Playa Car, Mexico. Call 1-888-ROGERS-1 today.
A young lawyer dreams of becoming a courtroom god.
I might have been wrong about that.
For him, it's about integrity.
We weren't getting all the facts.
Elliot told us the facts.
Until reality bites.
This is my case. You're here to carry the bags.
Jonah Gleason, Meet the Bar. The Associates, premieres January 16th on CTV. Brought to you by Cadillac, the fusion of design and technology.
I don't know.
And how sick and disgusting was Val Venus and Ivory this past week on SmackDown? And yeah, here we go.
Well, here's one man that saw that piece of videotape, and here's one man that really thought that it was sickening and disgusting. Look at the look in Billy Gunn's eyes. Coach, I think we got a fight on our hands.
Oh, it's flat out go time. It's Val Venus. It's the one Billy Gunn. And Billy Gunn absolutely livid by that disturbing piece of video of Val Venus imitating good old JR and Ivory imitating China with that neck brace on. That was sick.
That was, and you know, it's just a shame when you think about how China was on top of the world a couple months ago.
Absolutely.
With all the media promotion she was doing. And now it may have abruptly come to an end, but that's how it does happen in this sport, in this industry.
True.
There's not a certain calling card that says when you're going to make it to be a star and when your star quits shining bright.
At the hands of Val Venus and Ivory, you'll remember a couple of weeks ago, China taking that spike pile driver, now potentially career-threatening injuries to the ninth wonder of the world, China. Of course, we'll keep you updated over the next few weeks on her condition and her status. But you saw that very candid interview with JR that China did on Raw this past week. Wow. The tears. I felt so sorry for her because she's worked so tremendously hard. Oh, wow. This one's going to be over before it even gets started. The one, Billy Gunn, hook of the leg. Oh, wow. Val Venus just gets a shoulder up.
And what Billy Gunn needs to do here, and I know it's easier said than done, is try to keep his emotions in check. Because when you're not thinking right, when you're angry, you're not going to perform at your best level. And that's what Val Venus is counting on. Wow.
Val Venus over the top rope. Looked like he may have torqued his knee. Right out here in front of us at ringside. Wow, big forearm to the back of Val Venus by the one Billy Gunn. The crowd absolutely loves it on their feet. A sold-out crowd here on Heat. Oh, wow. Referee Mike Chioda doing his best to restore order. But right now, this is personal. This is personal, Michael Hayes.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Oh, wow. Oh!
Gotta watch the 10 count on the floor there, guys. Referee warning Billy Gunn. I don't know that a victory is at the top of Billy Gunn's list.
I really don't think he'd give a darn whether or not he beats Val Venus or not. Wait a second, Val Venus reversal. And, oh, wow. That can't be good on the knees. The one Billy Gunn going straight over the steel steps.
Looked like Billy tried to hold himself up and eventually just end up hurting his knee worse.
Well, Michael, real quick, we got to look forward to this week to Raw and SmackDown, what potentially could happen. You got a lot of things that could happen. You got Stone Cold Steve Austin. You got to believe, I don't know, but you got to believe that Mr. McMahon will be at Raw to try to defend his one and only daughter, Stephanie. You can't humiliate Stephanie like that and think that the man in charge, Mr. McMahon, is not going to do something about it.
Well, I can see that side of the coin. The other side of the coin is Stephanie has proven that she can handle herself quite well.
Yes, she
and
can.
Stephanie may have, no doubt Stephanie has been thinking about this pretty much all weekend long, I would think, and probably has a course of action maybe to take with one Stone Cold Steve Austin. I'll tell you this much. I can't see Stephanie just giving in and giving Austin the title shot just because he demands it.
Well, you got to believe that The Rock and The Undertaker will be looking for several individuals.
Well, who is the number one contender? It's hard to say.
No, we don't know because Rikishi blew it all up on Raw when he made a shocking return. Banzai dropped The Rock and Banzai dropped The Undertaker. So we don't know. All I do know is The Rock and The Undertaker are going to be pissed off. They're going to go after Kane. They're going to go after William Regal. They're going to go after Rikishi and probably Stephanie McMahon to boot. Oh, wow. Check out Val Venus hard with the knee to the steel ring post. Val Venus looks like he's gonna do it again, and he does it again to the knee of the one, Billy Gunn.
This is a concentrated, centered attack by Val Venus. Now, you know, Coach, on the other side of the proverbial coin, you gotta think about Y2J Chris Jericho.
Yeah.
Thoroughly embarrassed last week by Stephanie McMahon, Helmsley, and Kurt Angle,
yeah,
and Edge and Christian.
Yeah.
A collective effort. Y2J sometimes has more heart than brains. He's not going to sit back and take that.
Absolutely not.
I expect an attempt at retaliation from Chris Jericho. And what is it that the WWF fans love about Jericho?
A lot. His charisma. He's great in the ring. The women love him because he's really good looking. You know, me and him can really relate with that aspect of it all.
So
you know, there's a lot going on for Chris Jericho.
So you think he's real good looking, do you?
No, you know what I mean.
Thought you were like our audio board guy, Tim.
Yeah, go there, yeah. Timmy right now is going, Michael Hayes, shut up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm begging Tommy Carlucci in the truck to wake up and shut you up. Wow, what a big move by the one Billy Gunn. Looks like he may have hurt his leg. Now he's got Val Venus set up. Oh, wow, what a big suplex.
That could be
this
it.
This could be it. Hook of the leg. That will be it. Oh, wow. Val Venus just gets a shoulder up. The crowd thought it was over. I thought it was over. I know you thought it was over.
Yeah,
Tommy Carlucci wasn't over. Oh, he says no.
Val Venus, though, whether you like him, hate him, or what, he is a tough competitor.
Oh, wait. That's good. Referee Mike Chioda, that's why he's at the top of his game.
That was a good catch. And you're looking at Val Venus, Billy Gunn, two people who may be in the Royal Rumble match.
Oh, wait a second. The one Billy Gunn has Val Venus hooked up.
Oh,
oh, wow.
Sleeper neck breaker.
What a tremendous maneuver and a huge win.
Man.
Extracting at least a little revenge on Val Venus.
Wait a minute. Don't do it, Billy.
Billy Gunn saying he's going to pile drive Val Venus, but referee Mike Chioda doesn't want to let him do it. I don't blame him. An eye for an eye does not go here, Billy. Does not go here. Well, I tell you what, Michael, 3 weeks away approximately to the Royal Rumble. Can't wait. Next week, I'm sure we're going to have some more names entered into the Royal Rumble match. Can't wait for that. Happy New Year, everybody. For Michael Hayes, I'm the coach. As always, we'll see you right here on Heat. Next week.
You are watching CTV Sportsnet East, home of the Senators. Right now, on a special edition of You Gotta See This. It's been a year of the most compelling sports moments ever caught on tape. Dramatic, life-threatening accidents.
Holy